This motherboard is completely dead. To check such dead motherboard, I will pass the electricity through the motherboard. I have placed the probes on the neutral and line terminal of the connector. 229 volts are flowing through the connector. The motherboard is not functioning at all. Let me tell you how we know that it is not working. Some mini split air conditioner motherboards don't have LED lights installed in them through which we could know if it is working or not. But all the air conditioners outdoor motherboards have relays installed in them. When this switching relay works, a switching sound is heard from that relay, which indicates that the motherboard is working fine. This motherboard has LED light installed as LED 1. This LED light glows, and I came to know whether the motherboard is functional or not. Before checking the motherboard further, I will remove the plug of the motherboard from the electric socket. The things I told you at the start. For that, it is important. The motherboard should be physically fine. Then install the electricity. If the motherboard is in this condition, as I am showing you, which is completely burned, never pass electricity through such motherboard. You will first have to check it with the multimeter and then further work on this type of motherboard. The motherboard I am working on doesn't seem to be damaged. If you have just removed the motherboard from electricity, discharging these capacitors are important. Otherwise, these capacitor gives heavy shock. I have already attached the soldering iron with my workbench. Now I will attach the wires of the soldering iron to the capacitors to discharge the capacitor. No electric charge is present in the capacitors. Now I can further work on this motherboard without any hesitation. In this 1-ton air conditioner motherboard, 4 fuses are installed. I will make you understand why 4 fuses are installed in the motherboard. This fuse is installed with the IPM. This fuse is to protect the compressor. If for any reason, the compressor starts to take more amperes, this will disconnect. Then this small fuse, which is installed close to this big fuse. This fuse is of 2 amperes. This is to protect the SMPS circuit. If high amperes flow through the SMPS, it will disconnect and save the SMPS circuit from getting damaged. This large fuse is the main fuse of this motherboard connected to the main power supply. If this fuse disconnects, the complete motherboard will not power on. Why is this fourth fuse installed here? Most of the time this fuse is not installed in AC motherboards. The number of the fuse is FU2 and is of 3 amperes. When I followed the trace of this fuse, I found that it was attached to this red wire, which is the communication wire. If the communication of this motherboard goes faulty or more than 3 amperes current flows through the communication circuit, this fuse will be fused. Thus the communication circuit in this motherboard will not work. By putting the multimeter on continuity mode, I am checking the main fuse on this motherboard. The multimeter is beeping as well as showing readings, which means this fuse is fine. And I have already checked all the rest of the fuse. They are also fine. So I have experienced that whenever the bridge rectifier goes bad, or it gets short circuits, which makes the motherboard not to work. And I experienced it yesterday. I had this motherboard. The IGBT in this motherboard was bad. I replaced them with a new one. I didn't film a complete video on it, but I filmed a clip to show you. The IGBT was installed in these pads of the motherboard, and completely burned. I repaired this circuit. But still, this motherboard was not working. And after passing electricity through this motherboard, the PTC sensor was heating up. That gave me the idea that any IGBT is bad. The problem is that the high voltage pins of the IPM or the bridge rectifier is bad. The bridge rectifier was fine when I checked it with the multimeter. But when I am passing electricity through the motherboard, the PTC sensor is heating up a lot. The motherboard is also not working. I changed this old bridge rectifier with a new one. Then this motherboard started to work. Now the same way, let me tell you about this motherboard I am trying to fix. The bridge rectifier could be faulty. The high side of the IPM pins could also be bad. The other fault that is possible is in this SMPS circuit. It could have different faults. But most of the time, this switching IC goes bad as high voltages pass through it. If it goes bad, the motherboard will not power on and go dead. I will focus more on switching IC because I have checked both the IPM and the bridge rectifier. They are fine. I am desoldering the switching IC. The number of the switching IC I removed from the motherboard is MIP2K3. I have replaced the switching IC of this motherboard. I will check it by supplying electricity to this motherboard. Because most of the time when I replace switching IC it starts working. I have supplied electricity to the motherboard and it has not turned on. Now I will check whether the voltages are passing through the motherboard or not. You can see 5 volts are written on this capacitor C24. And 4.97 volts are flowing through this cap. This means the switching IC is passing the voltages. Capacitor number 20 should supply 12 volts. I will put the probes on it. And 12.7 volts are flowing through this capacitor. 15 volts are written on this pin of the IC number 4. And I heard the sound of switching right now. This means it is sometimes turning on after quite a while. This pad is ground. And 15 volts should flow on this pin. See, 15 volts are flowing through this pin. This means the switching IC is fine now. As it was not working fine before. The LED light of this motherboard has also been turned on. The switching relay in this motherboard has also started to work. This means this motherboard has been powered on. But here is a catch that this light turns on temporarily for some time. I have powered off the motherboard. Now I will again supply electricity to it. I will observe the temperature of different IC. Most of all my doubt is on the microcontroller. The temperature of the microcontroller is 49 degrees. And it has increased to 55 degrees. This is a very high temperature. The temperature of the microcontroller should not go above 35 to 39 degrees. As I am pointing the laser forward, it is showing 44 degrees. But as I move the laser of the temperature gun upward, the temperature of the microcontroller starts increasing. The motherboard has also turned on. Now I will check its temperature. Still, the temperature is high in the top corner of the microcontroller. The bottom corner has a low temperature. As this top corner of the microcontroller is heating up more than the bottom. This means I will focus more on the capacitor installed on the top side of the microcontroller. So I will check these caps or resistors installed in the surrounding of the microcontroller. Now off the camera, I have checked the component on the backside of the motherboard. The same I have checked the capacitor on the front side of the motherboard. I checked it off the camera to prevent this video from getting too long. And especially I checked the capacitors installed on this top side. So this capacitor number 98 is problematic. Let me show you how. When I check this capacitor on continuity mode, it is beeping, which means it is a short circuit. I have removed this capacitor. It is 4.7 microfarads and 50 volts. This capacitor is absolutely fine. The reason is when I check the pad where this capacitor is installed, see it is still beeping. This is the smoothing capacitor. Attached with the microcontroller 33 number pin and this other pin. Which are shorted with each other. The 33 pin is C. And the 34 number pin is the ground pin of the microcontroller. And this capacitor is used to pass fewer electric spikes through the microcontroller. Also to control the fluctuations in the electricity. But if these capacitor pads are shorted together, then it means the microcontroller has been short-circuited. The microcontroller is working, but as it heats up, and it turns off too, it has gone bad internally. And it is not possible to be repaired. A coincidence happened while filming this video. I got the same motherboard to get repaired. I have already shown you that the microcontroller of this motherboard is bad. The microcontroller of this motherboard is fine. Because most of the friends think that it is a typical fault. And I am not able to repair it. But the microcontroller getting bad is a major problem. Because when it gets bad then the complete motherboard goes out of order. Then we could not repair it. This other motherboard is completely working fine. Why will I remove the good microcontroller from a working motherboard? It will make no sense. Then this motherboard will go bad. So I will show you how this capacitor should behave. Now I am attaching the probes of the multimeter with the capacitor on continuity mode. See, the multimeter is not showing any kind of beep sound. This is indicating that the microcontroller is fine. And I have already shown you on this motherboard by removing the capacitor from the motherboard. But I will show you once again. See, when I attach multimeter probes, the multimeter is making a beep sound. This means the microcontroller is bad, and I have no solution to it. I will supply electricity to this OK motherboard. See, as I have passed electricity through this motherboard, it has turned on immediately. The LED light of this motherboard is also glowing. The switching relay also started to work immediately after supplying electricity through this motherboard. Now you would have understood that the problem in the microcontroller is not a typical problem but is a major problem. The only way to fix this kind of problem is to replace it with a good microcontroller, if you have one. So let's check the temperature of this microcontroller too. Its temperature from the top corner is 38 degrees. When I bring the laser to bottom corner, the temperature here is almost the same. So you can see this is the temperature of the good microcontroller. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And I will see you there. Thank you.